Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Let's talk about what happens when a series of charges are all moving in the same direction. For example, a current-carrying wire.
Oh.
We already derived the equation for the current in a wire. It equals charge carrier density times cross-sectional area times drift velocity times charge per carrier. And we know the magnetic force acting on each individual charge moving in a wire. Magnetic force equals the cross product of charge times velocity and magnetic field. However, what we want to know is the net magnetic force acting on all the charges moving in the wire. So we need to use charge carrier density equals the number of charges over volume, which means the number of charges equals the charge carrier density times the volume of the wire. The volume of the wire equals the cross-sectional area of the wire times the length of the wire. That means the magnetic force acting on all the moving charges in the wire equals the magnetic force acting on one charge multiplied by the number of charges, or the cross product of charge times velocity and magnetic field, all times charge carrier density times cross-sectional area times the length of the wire. Everything outside the parentheses is a scalar, so we can move all of those variables to the front of the equation. Now, we can substitute current in for charge carrier density times cross-sectional area times velocity times charge per carrier. So, we now have an equation for the magnetic force acting on a current-carrying wire. It equals the cross product of the quantity current times length and magnetic field. I will point out that we did move the vector symbol from the drift velocity of the charge carriers to the length of the wire.
I was about to ask that.
Hopefully you recognize that the direction of the average velocity of the charge carriers and the direction of the wire are the same. And it does make more sense to have the vector be on the length of the wire or the direction of the wire, because that is not an average value. And the drift velocity of the electric charge carriers is an average velocity. Now, realize that equation is for a straight wire. And when a wire does not follow a straight path or the magnetic field is not uniform over the wire, we need to use the integral form of that equation instead. And of course, we have the equation for the magnitude of the magnetic force acting on a straight current-carrying wire, current times length times magnetic field times the sine of the angle between the direction of the length and the direction of the magnetic field. And also, of course, we use the same wonderful right-hand rule we learned about last time to determine the direction of this magnetic force. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.